Old Mate Yorkie here, and the question on everyone's lips is, where in the world is Yorkie San Diego?
Here I am, player one. There, lost in wibbly wobbly timey wimey for some grimy crimey space and timey travelling limey. You got me. I am Yorkie San Diego at your service, and we are heading back to the Oregon Trail. Now, we're resuming this at 46%. We chased Roy off again. He's having fights with people. Not sure that's right. Oh yeah, we just got three here, so that must be right. Time to depart. We're heading Green River, Soda Springs, and Ford Hall. That's our route for today, player one. Green River North. The largest, most dangerous river crossing of the Oregon Trail, the Green River offers a little respite. Avoid contracting cholera, you get a Bible. Dorcelia's morale, get that. Or we can go Green River South, Fort Bridger. Wait, there's someone we want to meet at Fort Bridger? That's fine. Gonna go strenuous. Pick up the speed a little bit. I think the rations is good. Whichever way we go right now, we're heading for fishing. Rugged sagebrush fields stretch out before the party, making the end of the Continental Divide and the onset of the Oregon Country proper. So thirsty. Party's water supply is run low. If it's not refilled before long, dehydration and death may result. Small pond, let's replenish the water. Water is cloudy. Oh dear, she's got dysentery. That's not good. Let's give her some medicine. Dysentery 11 days. Let's reduce it some. The gradual yet inexorable onset of abdominal pain can only mean one thing. Contaminated water has surely given Celia dysentery. Oh god, he's got it too. Well, we'll press on and hope for the best. A grove of wild berries growing on the trail ahead. Lucian, go gather me some berries, will you please? Collect as many of the wild berries as you can find. Got 35 foodstuffs. I'll bring that down there. Put that up there. And we're done. This don't look good. Who are you? The party comes across a man lying in the middle of the trail. It seems though he's asleep. The man doesn't appear to have a campsite set up, so it's unclear how he came to be in this state. Oh, wake him up. Lucian, why don't you have a go at that? Excuse me, sir. He's up. Yawn. Did I doze off for a bit? Oh, were you the kind soul that woke me? Well, let me introduce myself. My name is Jack Keatley. I'm a rider for the Pony Express, fastest mail system of our times. Apologies for passing out in the middle of the road there. My recent treks have me going a 300-odd mile non-stop. It's been a few days since I've had any substantial rest. Just delivering some letters to Seneca now, and wait, where am I? This doesn't seem right at all. Can you help direct me? Yeah, we'll direct him. Lucin, you're good at this. God, it's around here somewhere. Well, that's all right. I'm sure I can figure it out. Oh, dear. Guess Lucin couldn't help him after all. Pardon me, well, I'll be running off now. These letters ain't going to deliver themselves. Bye, Jack. Try not to fall asleep now. You hear? But Jack Keatley departs. He somehow seems to drift off again. And we're approaching the fishing spot. Fish team in the water, let's go fishing. I've seen you're good at fishing, let's get you doing it. Size rainbow trout. Oh, a little nipper there on the razor back. No, that's end game then. That wasn't a lot. All right. Lucy managed to catch 25 pounds of fish and brings it all back to the storage. And proper. Oh, no. Okay, yeah, we know. Let's repack. There we are. We're in dire need of some repairs. Not more problems with the wagon. Wagon bed and canopy have been damaged. Lucian, get it fixed up, please. That didn't work out too good now, did it? We'll discard 5 units of food, that's fine. Got dysentery now. You're going to begin scratching the stomach furiously. It seems to have been bitten by many mites hiding in the grass. That's not good. Affliction, bacon grease. Yeah, we've got plenty of food. Place bacon grease on the worst bites. Bite juice, ease or itchiness. Probably going to stink to high heaven. Miles to Green River South, we're almost there. We got a ferry? Think we're going to be using it if we do. See what else is going on at the camp, though. The muddy red-brown waters of the mysteriously named Green River can be heard ahead. It's one of the deadliest crossings on trail. The party needs to be prepared. I got anything to trade? Trade supplies? Toolboxes, what do you want for that? We'll give you 50 meat, got plenty. Let's haggle though first. Elizabeth, you're the haggler. That seems fair. Right, 45 meat. I think that's all we need. Let's get some fixy up done. Oh, it ain't gonna let me. Move that there. Move that there. Move that there. Okay. We're gonna take a rest. I mean a proper rest this time. Steelers recover from dysentery. And now we're going to cross. And we're going to use the ferry. $5 per person. Yeah, that's no problem to us. I should have haggled, mind you. Party lights and ferry after a pleasant ride across the river. Now, we're heading Fort Bridger. Don't look like there's anywhere to collect pelts. Maybe we'll see some on the road. But in the meantime, go restore Elizabeth's health and collect pelts. Let's go to the south. Lagoon Sighton. Invigorated, they continue on their journey. I think we should let her recover first and then use that on her. The wagon's back wheel sinks in the desert, shifting sands. Its axle jams hopelessly mired, it will move no further. As things stand, pushing the wagon free will strain the party or worse, or might unpack its cargo. That's what we always do. Elizabeth is forlorn. Lucian's recovered from dysentery. I'm sick of you. Who the hell? Yeah, well, leave then. No! I need Celia more than Elizabeth. We've got to go, Elizabeth. Sorry. Well, we're down to just two people now. Please help me. Move along, strange. This man owes a healthy sum of money, $50 to be exact. The hell? Now, just what you're planning. Thank you. Who should argue? Lucian, you take this one. With a cool head and steady voice, Lucian manages to convince the predator to leave the man alone. At least for now. Fine. We'll leave you alone for now, Ralph, but we'll be back shortly. I'll be expecting interest. Oh, thank you, thank you. Please take my medallion. It'll take a minute to compose myself and then find the captain. I don't think I'm cut out for this kind of journey. Yeah, just make your way back. You'll be fine. The party comes across a pair of musicians performing for a small crowd on the trail. Music is good, but it's drowned out by the sound of their bickering. Could they be the brother and sister mentioned by Lewis Southwest? And out of tune. You're not on beat. I've just about had enough of you, Rosetta. How do you expect to draw a crowd if you don't put any heart and soul into your music? Lacking an audience, brother, not heart and soul. I told you it was a silly idea to perform for emigrants on the trail, but did you listen to me? There doesn't seem to be much hope of hearing the siblings play again, unless the argument can be resolved. We'll spot the sister. I think she's right. After all, what good is performance if there's nobody to hear it? All you need is a way to draw a large crowd. I say, Marvin, even this here stranger can see we're playing for the wrong place, and why can't you? There's plenty of people on the trail. You're looking at some of them right now, Rosetta. Mind you, I've no idea who they think they are. The musical duo looks at the party expectantly, waiting for a response. How should the party introduce themselves? Mention Louis Southworth. Louis Southworth, fiddler, why? We saw him play back in the pension. Really know him? He wants to put a band together to play at Fort Boise. Gonna be a big show, and he asked for you specifically. Did he now? Well, if that's true, then we can't really so know. But I want you to swear on your honour that you're not trying to pull the wool over our eyes. Lucian, you've got at this. Damn it, didn't work. What a load of hogwash. If Louis Southworth really wants me to perform in his band, why didn't he come himself? Well, I'm convinced Fort Boise might be a long way off. If you're producing a show, then I'll take my chances. Applause will drown out my dear brother's complaining. So a show at Fort Boise, is it? That's a long way to walk, carrying my instrument. Much rather store it in your wagon, if you don't mind. That will arrange for my own transport at Fort Hall. You can meet me there, I'll pick up my instrument from you and carry it the rest of the way. I trust you won't drop it before then, will you? That's a bit of a liberty there. Never mind. Ten miles Fort Bridger. We're almost there, player one. Nina reaches the wagon, checks the group's supplies, and emits a loud yelp and stumbles backwards. A snake hastily slithers out. Let's treat her! Lucian, you're good. Lucian treats Celia's wound by a medicine to clean bandage. That's fine. At first glance, it's not clear why this scant collection of log cabins merits the title of a Fort Bridger at all. Nevertheless, the party is more than grateful to have arrived. As the party arrives at the fort, someone rushes out to meet them. Elizabeth looking worse for wear after spending some time alone. Elizabeth, welcome back. Look, you lot are insufferable, but I need a group if I'm to survive. Come back in, Elizabeth. You're fine. I'm glad you see it my way. We are strong together. Missed out on both of them, unfortunately. There's Fort Bridger. There's Ava here. My friends, you made them just in time too. The wedding is just about to get started. Good to see you, my friends. I'm glad that you are able to be here to see our union, I promise. We are gathered here today, says Jim Bridger, to witness a union between this man and this woman, Ava and Douglas. For my powers as the owner of the fine fort, I now pronounce you man and wife. I do. I do too. Yeah. You may kiss. There we go, player one. Oh, yeah. It's a happy marriage. At least, it's a happy marriage day. Who knows what the future holds? It is done. We are married. Oh, happy day. I'm glad you are present, friends. Please, I would like for you to meet my new family. So these are the travelers I've heard so much about. Pleasure to meet you. My son and my new daughter-in-law have told me much about you. I wish to thank you for your service to my family. My son has explained you were instrumental in the meeting. I wish for you to have this in the measure of my family's thanks. May help you get to Oregon. Farewell and safe travels, my friends. I hope we can find each other again. Perhaps once we're all living large in Oregon. Quest complete. Star-crossed lovers. See if we can trade. Flies. Don't need any of that, actually. Maybe some bullets. Because we were out, weren't we? Well, damn, you don't want much, do you? How much meat and stuff do we have? Got 12 fish. 79 meat. 27 hardtack. Oh. Got a lot of flour. We got 200 flour. Can find a way to store it. I don't really see a way to store all that, though. Well, we could get rid of the fish. Like that. I don't think there's any way to... get anything else moved around low. No. No, we don't have enough places, Breeder. Get that back in there. Wouldn't even have enough flour with that, so back. Can sell our fish. Take it away, Elizabeth. That's one thing you're prepared for. Nice. Nice haggling. Take a rest. Go to your Feldman's boss paddock and rest at night in the wagon. Seek lodgings for $6. Nice. Soundly sleeping weak. Let's depart now. Oh crap, I didn't look at services. I needed to do that. Alright, Soda Springs it is. 140 mil. Collect meat, we get a coffee. Reach within 10 days, we get 50 gold. Or 50 coins. Well, we need to go to the goose side first. Off we go. Looked like a dead buffalo. One Cody collected. Bites and lies on the dirt beside the trail, unmoving. It doesn't appear to have any external wounds or evidence of sickness. Let's have a look and let's investigate, shall we? Celia! Celia holds her breath and investigates the carcass. She can see nothing external, suggests the meat is unsafe. Concludes it's likely the bison simply perished of old age. I don't know that we got anywhere to store it, to be honest. We'll just leave. We've got 306 pounds of food. We don't really need any more. Oh god, lost some meat. As the sound of the gunshot slowly fades, the party approaches the man on the trail. Seems to be nursing his foot. You hear that he's badly injured. Without medical attention, he may not survive. Alright, give him some medicine, that's fine. Thank you, stranger. My name is Sydney. I was trying to rendezvous with my captain. My rifle misfired when I was travelling. Don't make the same mistake again. Godspeed to you. Off we go. I guess we're going down here. A nondescript trail. Dust swirls and partly obscuring vision, making it hard to breathe. Can't see anything. Party's full stop. Continuing such a stop would only be a disaster. Eventually, the storm clears, revealing that some of the ox broke from their yokes during the commotion. Let's have a see if we can search for them. Lucian, you're good at this. It stinks, mind you. We ought to see about doing something about that. 8 hours lost. Lucian eventually finds the oxen, carrying behind the rock. Dust build up as they were buffeted by the wind. There we go. Leaning back, Lucian sets him on the yoke once again. I can continue to roll. The party takes him on to choose which trail to follow. Got fish there. Got camping there. That also lead us to another dragoon. Now, Lucian. Your health ain't great, your hygiene ain't great. Let's give you some hygiene at least. I may have to take a break, let me just check. I'll be right back, Player One. Right, Player One, we're back. Several discarded and broken crates sit on the dust of the trail. They appear to have been discarded deliberately. Maybe they fell from a previous wagon. Let's search for supplies. Lucian, you're our boy. Spend some time letting the broken crates open and searching. It's a trial of patience and care, but it's rewarded a number of supplies. We got a knife. We got two medicine. An abandoned campsite lies covered in dust and mud. The previous occupants left it in good enough condition to be reused. I think we'll set up camp. And we'll have ourselves a little old rest. God, it awakens well rest and ready for another long day of travel. Looks like we might not be doing the hunting. Paddy hems more up on a small pool of still clear water. Perhaps drinkable, perhaps not. Lucian, take a look, see if it is. Mouth water immediately spits in the dust. There's no mistake in such rank order. It's poisoned. Knowing the water to be undrinkable, the party passed it by, checking further into the desert. Unbelievably, Sydney can be seen ahead, once again nursing his foot. Seems he had another near-fatal accident. It's clear he's badly injured. I'll give him some medicine. Thank you again, travellers. I'm not sure how it happened again, but I think perhaps best I simply travel unarmed. Wagon is wearing out. Let's repack, see what we can do. We can use that. And I think Celia. So the spring's coming up close. We've got less than a dozen miles. Ouch. Elizabeth underestimates the blade of a worn knife and put herself on its edge while handling it. Use three herbal remedies. Lucian, get it treated, will you, my man? And she's got an infection, that's not good. We're getting close, real close. Then we'll have just one more step on this third leg. Even from yards away, hissing pools and naturally carbonated water can be seen bubbling forth. This soda spring is a notable landmark for travellers and tourists alike. Oh, we got that. Let's have a chat. The travellers here clearly aren't shy about trying the famous bubbling spring water. Let's talk to Jane. Hello again, traveller. It's certainly amazing how often we meet on the trail, I'd say. My little Mary has not stopped talking about you folks since we last met. You really left an impression on her. Keeps asking questions about your group, but I have to keep telling her I don't know. Perhaps you'll take the time to talk to her. I could use a quiet moment to catch up on some reading. She's just waiting by... she's just by the water. Don't worry, I've been keeping an eye on her. Make sure she doesn't run off again. Let's have a chat with little Mary. Hey, everyone. Mummy said I might see you again. Did you come to play in the water too? Yeah. Hey, it's fun. You'll see. Mummy says you can use the water here to make a special drink. Can you show me how? Sure, we'll do that. I've no idea how myself, but I'm sure someone can. The party spends some time. I'm off on the side here. Yeah, lad, TikTok knocked my camera aside. There we are. Little Mary's eager to take a big gulp of the effervescent beverage. Wow, this is so good. The bowls tickle my throat. Little Mary sips the beverage with speed and alacrity, perhaps befitting someone twice her size. Been long before she begins to hiccup. My stomach feels from her hiccup. Puts her stomach moments pass and she struggles against the inevitable. Brrr. Oh my, I'm sorry. Please don't tell Mummy that I did that. She'll be upset with my bad manners. Hey, better out than in, little Mary. Little Mary frantically apologised for her belch, looking thoroughly embarrassed. I say let it rip. The travellers here aren't shy about trying the famous bubbling spring water. Oh, we also got Charles here. What do you got for us, Charles? The water here is naturally carbonated, meaning it's got bubbles in it. All right, we'll make a drink. Party pours some of the spring water into their canteens, mixing it with drinks of their own to make a delicious soda. Travellers clearly aren't shy, but we don't need to talk to anyone else. Can we trade? Is there anything useful? We need toolboxes. What are you asking? We can use one Dragoon medal. Medicine might not be a bad thing to have. Haggle. Elizabeth, you're our girl. Seems fair. Alright, let's see what you're asking. Two Dragoon medals? Yeah, I don't know that I want to do that, really. Reconsider. Bullets. No, we're not going to go for the bullets. We will get that. Now, let's have a look at the wagon. And some health. Oh. Can't use that either. Well, that's dashed inconvenient, isn't it? Let's get rid of that. We can lose that. We can move that down there. We can move that there. I can put that there. Now. Can we just try and see if there's anywhere else I can put things? We can keep that. What about pelts? I don't need all 10. Sell pelts. Haggle. Elizabeth, you're our girl for this. Seems fair. Right. Sell 3 pelts. Sell 1 pelt. Sell 1 pelt. There we are. Take a rest. And with that, we can depart. Final stretch of legs free. On to Fort Hall. 5 days of 41. Avoid contracting dysentery for something to please the crew. We've got plenty of food, so I'm not worried about hunting. We're not going to get anything for hunting either. If I had to leave the one of the Soda Spring behind, it's a relatively short stretch to the safety of Fort Hall, so the journey will be no less perilous. When checking the oxen, Silly noticed one of them panting and sweating. Won't be slowed and lethargic. It's likely been affected by heat and the constant beating sun. To feed the animal, the ox should be allowed to rest in the shade of the wagon. We'll do that. We don't want to lose the oxen. Still, the sick ox from the yoke and lead it to the shade. Given time to cool down, the ox breathing slows and it returns what appears to be normal. Elizabeth died? Well, damn. The most wasted of days are those without color. We'll let that go. The wagon jostles. Oh, dear Lord. Let's repack. We can lose 10 food. We've got plenty of food. That we're keeping. Greetings, strangers. You must be my ride. I knew the captain would come through for me. Just drop me off at Fort Hall, if you please. Let's go. Without waiting for a reply, the strange, annoying man crams himself in the wagon as comfortably as he can. All right, let's head down here for another one. Oh, God. Got to repack, don't we? And I don't think we've got any chance of doing that. Let me use this. Okay, we can. We probably can. Use that up. Got some good repair on the wagon there. When checking the flower, see that you notice some of it has become waterlogged. Well, that's unfortunate. Now we've got plenty of food. Get rid of the waste. There's the other soldier. I know you're that group that our idiot captain sent after us. I won't lie, traveling alone has been boring. Let's play a little game. I'll challenge you to a battle of wits. If you answer a few of my questions correctly, I'll rejoin the party. Well, go on then. Good, let's get started. What is 3/7 of a chicken, 2/3 of a cat, and 2 1/4 of a goat? Oh, Chicago. Yeah, that works. That's right. Try another. I have branches, yet I have no leaves, no trunk, no fruit. What am I?
A bat has branches.
That's right. What runs but never walks, murmurs. That sounds like a river to me. Has a bed but never sleeps. Bones but never talks. Has a mouth but never eats. River. Ranger's fine, I'll prepare here for a minute, then I'll meet up with the captain. Take my medallion as proof. Your relative wit. Certainly better than yours, isn't it, my friend? Good to see you again. I've been listening to this bass player perform. He's quite good, isn't he? More importantly, did he manage to bring my instrument? I'd quite like to get a move on. In the back there. Everything seems to be in order. I'll see you at Fort Boise for the performance. It's a shame that Marvin won't be there, but it's not your fault. Set of waves goodbye. Hi there, name's Raymond. I don't suppose you could spare some change with this old performer, could you? Just a few dollars short of some new boots. Raymond's same skill at playing the double bass. He'd be a perfect fit for the Louis Southworth band. Invite him to the band. Got the band at Fort Boise. Sorry, no can do. I'm giving up on music as soon as I've earned a bit of money. I'm going to go live in the mountains and start trapping furs. Raymond doesn't seem interested in joining Louis Southworth's band. Your playing is fine. Rebellion talented musician, sir. Are you sure you won't give up on... You sure you want to give up on your playing? It's such a shame for the world never to hear such a fine performance as yours. Very kind of you, but I'm afraid so. After all these years of playing, I've heard nothing more than a callous finger. In the mountains, I'd have a shot at making real fortune. Raymond seems quite enchanted by the air of mountain loping. Raymond is persistent, but the party still believes he can be convinced. Have you thought about the cold in the mountain? Right? Cold up there, you know. I've heard stories of men and priest deaths in their sleep. Can't bear to imagine something like that happening to you. Of course it's cold, that's where I got this thick coat, see? I got it second hand for a real fur trapper. I'll admit it's probably seen better days, but I'm sure I can fix it up. Much the party frustration Raymond is holding on. And seems about crowds. Please reconsider, do remember the adulation of the crowd. The tears and the applause, are you sure you want to leave all that behind? Performing in front of others is a lot of pressure, and I've never been particularly good with crowds. Much rather keep the company, oh dear. When Raymond mentions his friends, the party senses a weakness in his facade. Celia, my friend, why didn't you do this? You wouldn't have any friends in the mountains, Raymond? Not a one. You'd be alone for months with nobody to talk to. Do you understand? Celia delivers the final blow with calculated precision. I never thought of it like that. I was just imagining a big adventure. You're right. I really would be on my own. Raymond suddenly seems very pensive. Well, except for the bears and the wolves, they could keep you company, I suppose. Are you much of an animal lover? All right, he made your point, I guess. I'm not really cut out for mountain life, after all. You got it, player one. Here you are. You can have my coat. I don't think I'm going to need it. It smells a bit funny anyway. Where do you say the band's performing? Fort Boise? I'm planning travelling that far with my double bass. I can kind of carry it for me. Yeah, we'll take it. You're looking for other instruments. I hear there's a salesman who went south Snake River. I was going to meet with him myself, see how much I could sell my double bass. No need for that now. Reaper. Get some medicine treatment doing. Right. Stop. This'll do, I can walk the rest of the way, my friends. I have my medallion as a prize. I've got no idea what you can do with it, but I want it, so enjoy. The group knows flower supply getting low. Should bake some hardtack. I think they'll push on. All right, we're getting close. Player one, I reckon we're about here. Rolling in. As the imposing white grey walls of Fort Hall rise into view, clamour and hubbub of the trade is already evident. Several tents around the fort, many of which no doubt belong to hopeful fur traders. Who would you like to heal? No one. Bit of winner, I don't really care about that, we're not doing other ones. As the party arrived at the fort, someone rushed out to meet them. It's Roy, looking worse for wear after spending some time alone. Roy has rejoined the party. Welcome back, Roy. Thank you for showing me kindness. Maybe try not to fight so much this time. Leg 3 of 5 completed, player 1. I'll just trade up in here in Fort Horn. Be done. No one has talked by the look of it. Services. Blacksmith. Welcome, what can I do for you? Looks like the trail's been hard. 44 coins it is, that's no problem at all. Do I need a physician or a barber? Celia might need a barber. All done. Stop at the store. What is it we got at the moment? Is it SCXS at the moment? Murphy wagon. That is a Murphy wagon. Same as we already got. Be nicer to have that, but no, we ain't got that, so don't worry. Right, let's buy some stuff. I don't actually think I need any more of that. Now. Now she is set up. Everything else looks pretty good right now. Any trading? Four toolboxes could be good. Let's haggle. Roy, you're the best at that. Stop it, sir. You're making me blush. We'll take 51 flour. We can lose some of that. The wagon grease. What are you going to reduce it to? Birdie bullets. We'll use it. Let's have a look at the wagon. Look at 35 bullets, that's fine. And it looks like everything else is pretty good. That's nice. Don't really want to use any of that up. And I think that's it, so let's take a rest. And we'll pay for lodgings. Celia's no longer forlorn. And that's where we leave it for now, player one. Join me in a couple of days, where we'll pass on to Lake 4 or 5, heading for the Snake River. Bye now.